Welcome back to Oakfield Farm. There is a queue of traffic going on for quite a while on this roundabout in all directions. If you watched my last episode, you'd know why that is. That is because of this catastrophe. We have rolled our John Deere, fully loaded, with our Herbert's Bill trailer that we just bought with 24 bales on it. I think it's for 416. Yeah, 24 bales, yeah. So what we need to do is we need to run back to the shop as quickly as we can. That looks rather uncomfortable. That looks rather unfortunate. So we need to quickly as we can run back to the shop. I'll just turn the help window off. Run back to the shop and rehire the telehandler and see if we can turn this tractor back the right way. Hopefully some of that traffic clears while we're away. If you watched my last episode, this happened right at the very end. It's a good example as to why you don't overload a bill trailer. I did just return the telehandler as well, so we need to rent a telehandler. Anything will do. And we need some kind of fork on the front. Probably that one would be best. We'll just rent that, and we will go and try and sort something out here. So we'll do this as quickly as we can. I do need to turn off four-wheel steering though. I'll just leave it on. This is an emergency situation. I'm sure the police won't mind too much if I break the rules on that one. So I'll just turn the hazards on as well. Careful not to cause any more accidents. So you are not actually allowed to drive on UK roads with four-wheel steering on. And that is in fact against the law. Oh, it appears our tractor has repaired itself. So what we'll do is we'll have a look at it here. I do have quite an issue. So just get it off of the ground right here. Park it here. Detach the trailer. So obviously it repaired itself. It turned back over, which is good news. But what we will do is we will just play along as if that never happened. I do have the map auto save feature on, hence the map stopping every now and then. So we'll do is we'll actually leave this tractor here for the time being. And we will hitch this trailer up onto this hired telehandler. Turn off the sure all of the tension belts are fastened. And I need to turn off four-wheel steering. And what we'll do is we will head along to the farm very, very slowly indeed. That's just rude. You should have waited. Do is I will reduce the speed down to 5 miles an hour. Really? It's just sometimes the AI traffic in this game is just shockingly bad. Did that turn off for the steering? It didn't. Right. That did it? Yes, that did. So a very, very slow run back to the farm here. Just because of how unsteady this load is. And we will tow the tractor back at a later time. But that was a very, very bad thing to happen. So we do have our hazards on. We are sitting at 3 miles an hour. You can't even see the top of the trailer. That's not something that should have happened, but that just shows you the level of physics in this game. If you overload a trailer too high, it will fall over. Time to take a screenshot. Moving. That worked. Yeah, that worked. Turn that back on. I really wish that wouldn't come on every time that is. It has the same button for the AI helper as it does for hiding the HUD. We need to get that camera clipping mod as well. So I'm just going here quicker. It's not something like we really don't want to get to the verge. So this tractor is somewhat slower, which is no bad thing. This telehandler in order to help me put the trailer back on to its wheels, but it's done that for me anyway. It's within the straps held. Obviously in real life they probably wouldn't have. They would have probably failed. I expect they would have anyway. It depends on the rating of the straps themselves. Go in the farm this way just to get off of the main road. We'll probably catch some branches and damage our bins a little bit more. That's probably not something that is actually, oh dear, probably not something that is actually implemented in the game, but we will just assume it is. So this trailer is obviously going to be pretty extensively damaged after tipping like that. It would, I expect, at the very least have damaged some of the lighting and probably some of the electrics as well. Farm is just here on the left. I take this corner very slowly. I don't mind if I drive over one of those rocks with the tractor since the trailer doesn't hit any. So it's probably not the best way to go as it is rough. We take our time with it. My intention to repair this was to actually take all of the straps off and let bales fall off the trailer. Disconnect the trailer from the tractor. and turn the tractor back onto its wheels, and then turn the trailer back onto its wheels, and then collect the bales after that. And I was going to collect them in another episode, but this kind of works in our favour. Obviously, a very helpful member of the public has repaired the damage for us, turned the trailer back on. And obviously, while we were away, the police obviously would have gotten some recovery company in to do that for us. So going up this hill, so it's quite steep. But for the time being, we're actually going to park this trailer in this silage bunker here, just to get out of the way. Park it somewhat central so we can get all the way around it. So we're not really zoomed out here, not sure why that is. I'll just turn everything off on this. It would have been quite badly damaged. At that kind of angle, this bottom kick plate here would have been folded in, the lights would have broken, and the wheels would have gotten damaged, as well as this ramp here would have probably been pushed in, obviously when all the bales would have came off. So not to mention this whole front section here would have probably been completely destroyed. This pin, hook and pin here would have been twisted, probably snapped as well. So luckily that kind of thing isn't implemented into the game, but even still, that was certainly a bad idea to overload it like this. And that's not something we are going to do in the future. So we will recover our John Deere at a later date. What I would do with that is, given that it had such a bad crash, we will recover it at a later date and park it in that shed there for a period of time to get some repair work done to it, because it would have been extensively damaged, if not a complete write-off. And if it does turn out to be a complete write-off, we will replace it with probably another John Deere, maybe a bigger one. So in the meantime, this in fact will be a shorter video because of the unfortunate event that happened. So what we'll do is we'll go into our online store here and buy a pressure washer. And we'll place it somewhere central to the farm, probably around here. I think there is actually a water thing here. So we'd want it, we'll just put it over here. Just put it right there. To clean our equipment. This is certainly not something you want to fall into. That is the silage slurry store. Do not enter toxic gas. Ah, see, I didn't know you could do that either. You can actually close it to make it a bit safer. That's actually a really, really cool feature. I do like the level of detail that is in this map. It is astounding. Warning, not drinking water. No, it wouldn't be, but it will be used for our animals and greenhouses if we get some. So here's our little pressure washer. I'm not sure if it reaches across here. And it gets to there, so we could really hose down our cultivator here for really no reason whatsoever other than to just make it look a little bit more presentable. Just like that. Go and return the holes. So, on that note, we got the build trailer back to the farm. We do need to go and get the John Deere tractor. We will actually go and get that in the next episode. I just need to install the mod that allows me to tow. And yeah, we will go and get it. But I do apologize for this being a shorter video, but we are now a tractor down. And I suppose I could technically lease one, but that's probably what I'll do, is I will probably return this to the shop at a later point, but for the time being it can stay on the farm. So if you are enjoying this series and my series of unfortunate events, then please like this video, comment on this video, and subscribe to my channel. There is more content like this uploaded on a very regular basis. I do enjoy playing Farm Simulator, so I do quite a lot of videos on it. Hopefully you enjoy watching it as much as I enjoy making these videos. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.